I wanted to talk about genetics and autism. I don't know if any of you have seen the movie 2001, A Space Odyssey. I do think that this movie is an Aspie movie, primarily because in the movie it focuses on the evolution of man, the development of the species, and the thinking more so of the mind. And exploring other dimensions and going beyond this physical world into another state of consciousness or dimension. If you can imagine the species of human and you look at the differences in humans, in the opening of that movie, 2001 A Space Odyssey, there are apes in a sort of a desert setting. And in the setting, there are apes that pound away using a bone, and there's another ape that actually, from memory, is able to craft that bone into a weapon, into a tool to kill a beast. And that is primarily the evolutionary movement of the Aspie or whatever into being able to go beyond the herd. I think we live in a world that is pretty much controlled by corporations and by establishments, and those of us that are different in our ways of thinking and functioning just don't always comply with that establishment, and we often have the challenges that the corporations and the powers that be around us are inflicting their tribal like instincts on us, and we cannot be able to evolve, and we thus get bred out or we perish as a species. I tend to think of the Aspie mind as something that is really, is it explained by genetics? And if you can imagine that over time the genetics is evolving, I mean the genetics of autism, because I think there is, I've noticed in the news here that there has been an increase in anti-vaccinations because there's this belief that vaccines cause autism, and I don't really want to go into that because I don't believe that they do cause autism. But I think that those of us on the spectrum tend to challenge or threaten the authorities because the controlling mechanisms don't want people to think. They don't want people to question. And they want to control people and keep people in one state of mind. If you look at Tesla and Edison, for example, from what I understand, and I do need to research this more, that it was actually Tesla that invented electricity for free to use. Tesla had an Aspie type of mindset that he was able to create this Tesla coil, which from what I understand was able to create natural energy into power. But Edison came along, the socially abled Edison, and the others, powers that be, and saw Tesla as a threat, someone to get rid of, because he threatened corporations and he threatened establishments. And so Tesla perished. And this is what concerns me with the Aspies, is that primarily we're seen as a threat because we don't represent the status quo. So with the Aspie mindset, I think that in the situation of Tesla, and Tesla does need some research because he is an interesting person in that he was able to have a mind far superior than that of other people. And if you look at Edison, for example, Edison, from what I understand, created a few objects, created the phonograph, I'm quite sure, or whatever. But I think that history has dealt Tesla a nasty blow, because I think that all the work, really, the hard work that Tesla did and the intelligence that Tesla did pretty much just fell in the wayside because the socially abled world didn't understand Tesla's achievements. And in the socially abled world, those of us on the spectrum have difficulty surviving because we find small talk and chit-chat difficult. we're more methodical, and we're more sort of intellectual in our ways of thinking. And that's the way I see it anyhow. But I think the evolutionary step for those of us on the autism spectrum is that more and more adults need to actually sort of be able to succeed methodically and practically in the world, and to be able to outdo the establishment and the controlling forces. And I think that those of us on the spectrum, we represent challenge and fear because we don't always comply or conform to the way that the world's expected to be. And I think also that difficulties can occur within establishments and corporations where difficult people can use mechanisms to their advantage to suppress and control people that are on the spectrum. And we really are fighting an uphill battle all the time because we just are still seen as a subspecies of human, but we're not a subspecies of human. And this is what I keep wanting to say and reinforce, that those of us on the spectrum have very, very capable attributes. But, you know, unless more adults start to realize this and start to accept it and work upon it, the world isn't going to change. And why also do so many of us on the spectrum have difficulty in the school system? Work that one out. Because we don't find, we can't be controlled. We're not conformed. We're individual thinkers. We belong to ourselves. We think differently. We function differently. I would encourage anybody to watch the movie 2001: A Space Odyssey and to have a look at it. I do believe that Stanley Kubrick, for example, and Peter Sellers, whom both had some influence in the movie, well, Kubrick, the director of it, were both on the autism spectrum. So maybe this might beg you to ask the questions of exactly what is happening for those of us on the spectrum, and why are we seen as a threat, and why are we not able to achieve our rightful place in this world. And I could go on and more on with more examples of this. In fact, I think I'll probably start to write more contributions about it. But just think about Tesla. Just think about him for a moment. Was he unrecognized, and was he a broken man because society couldn't handle the intelligence and the abilities that Tesla had, and that Tesla was also a threat? And was Edison really that gifted and talented as he's made out to be, or was it really Tesla that was the person that was gifted and talented? Thanks very much for watching.